Hey, so today we're going to start the analysis of a silver copper alloy lab. It takes 2 days. I mean, not the whole day, but today we're going to get it started. So I have in my hand some special dimes. These are not just any dime. They're silver dimes. They're an alloy of copper and silver. So obviously you can't see that there's copper in there. But there is. So these aren't just your normal dimes. These cost a little over a dollar. And I usually have to go to like a rare coin, like a sketchy place to get them that's got bars on the outside windows. But I do it for you. So here's a whole bunch of them. And then I took one and just snipped it in half with a tin snips. So we're only going to use half of a silver dime for this procedure. Okay, so all we have to do is first take the mass of this guy. So we'll bring in the electronic valence so we can find its mass. And then we're just going to put it in some nitric acid. So for today, this should be pretty simple. So turn it on, let her boot. And here's the only piece of data that I have to record today. It's just the mass of my alloy sample. So I'm getting about 1.30 grams. 1.30 grams. Cool. Okay, so that's taken care of. Then the only other thing we need to do is put it in a little bath of nitric acid for a day or so. We're going to use about 10 milliliters of nitric acid, and it'll be relatively concentrated. This is about 6 molar. I would choose not to drink this, ingest this in any way. All right, so there we're about halfway. And then we're going up a little more to about 6 milliliters. Okay, then all we gotta do is throw the acid in a small beaker. In goes the alloy. And then we just let it sit and react for a little while. It's probably not gonna do too much right away. And there you can kind of see it. Eventually, it'll start to fizz and bubble a little bit, and it gives off a toxic gas. So when I see like this kind of toxic brown gas being released, then we know that it's time to get it in the fume hood. But it takes, I don't know, maybe like 20 minutes or so to see too much of a change. So for now, we've got the dime in the acid. I'll cover it with a watch glass, move it over to the fume hood. And then when we come back tomorrow, it should be reacted. And we should have a solution of zinc, or not zinc, a solution of copper ions and silver ions. And once they're in the ion form, we should be able to separate them from each other by kind of a selective precipitation process. All right, so that's all for now.